For previous users of Solidworks, you might be familiar with a useful feature called Indent. While there isn't a similar command in Fusion 360, I will show you how the same effect can be replicated in Fusion 360 with a series of steps. Here, we have a sphere and a cube. The intention is to use this sphere as a cutting tool to create a socket in the cube. If you look at the browser, you can see that I have created them as separate bodies and named them accordingly. So do take note that they are not merged together, as you can see from the cross-sectional view here. Now, I want to create a socket that has a 2mm clearance or offset from the sphere. The first step is to create a copy of the sphere. Select the sphere from the browser, hit Ctrl+C to copy, or you can right-click and copy. Then, hit Ctrl+V to paste, or you can also right-click and paste. A copy of the sphere appears in the browser, and a Move Copy window pops up. We are going to keep the copied sphere in the exact same location as the original, so just hit OK. Rename the copied sphere and hide the original sphere by clicking on the eye. To create the offset of 2mm, we are going to use the Offset tool. Go to Modify, Offset Face, and select the sphere. Enter a distance of 2mm. You can see that the sphere enlarges by 2mm all round. To use this enlarged sphere as a cutting tool, go to Modify, Combine. The target body is the body that you want to cut, which in this case will be the cube. Now, we are using the sphere as the cutting tool. So for two bodies, select the sphere. For operation, select cut. In our case, we are not doing an intersect. So leave the new component option unchecked. After cutting, we do not need the enlarged sphere anymore. So leave the Keep Tools option unchecked. Once you hit OK, the socket is created and the sphere copy disappears. You can confirm this also in the browser. If we unhide the original sphere, we can see that the socket has a 2mm clearance from the sphere. To truly demonstrate the power of this, we can go back in time and try to move the original sphere. Go to the timeline and roll back to the point before a copy of the sphere was created. Go to Modify and select Move Copy. Select a sphere and drag it to a new location. Roll the timeline all the way to the end, and you can see that the socket regenerates accordingly. This also works if you change the size of the sphere. Alright, hope that you have found this useful. I will see you in the next one.